Well, we know that eating disorders are often very hidden, and people have often very great misunderstandings of what an eating disorder is. And the stereotype of eating disorders being a young woman with anorexia nervosa is probably because of that historical context, because that was the first eating disorder to be described, to be recognised, to be talked about by doctors, and to sort of get into medical consciousness, if you like, and then public consciousness has become the predominant image. But eating disorders occur across all age groups, and they occur across men as well as women. And one of the atypical presentations is becoming more typical these days is young men who are struggling with body size and body image issues, but they're wanting to build up muscles, so they're using steroids in very inappropriate ways. Other atypical ways are the people who have lost a lot of weight and are essentially in a starvation state, very similar to people with anorexia nervosa, but they're not underweight. So the doctor says to you, well, you can't have an eating disorder because you're not underweight. In fact, they can have as severe as an eating disorder as someone with anorexia nervosa. They may have lost 20, 30, 40 kilograms of weight, for example, and be in such a severe state. And we call that atypical anorexia nervosa.
We're getting a lot more cases of what we call atypical anorexia nervosa. So, and what that involves is that the person has all the signs and symptoms of anorexia nervosa, which we know is a very serious psychiatric and medical crisis in a person's life, but they look a normal weight. And that's because their weight loss started when they were bigger. So when they come to us, they can look a normal weight, and there's a bit of a danger of saying, oh, the person looks okay. I can't see any really big problem. But actually, they can be as medically compromised and as in much danger as somebody who's at a very, very low BMI and looks obviously very ill and needs to go to the emergency department. So keeping in your mind again the idea that we can't tell from the outside if a person has an eating disorder. So we really do need to do the kind of going in, finding out across those sets of signs.